Hi there, beautiful souls. Greta Robertson here, CEO of the Purple House Wellness Center. And also, I coach people privately how to break through their obstacles and money blocks and remove, pain and constriction that my clients have in their lives. So tonight, I want to be with you for 15 or 20 minutes and take you from a place of tension and constriction to a place of freedom and abundance, if you like. And so I will be talking about money for a little bit first, and then I will do a short meditation that is going to make you feel really free and at ease in yourself, that will help you to relax and to set you up for money to flow into your life. I love talking and working with my clients and dissolving their money issues, because money triggers a lot of emotions in us, in all of us. We have a relationship with money and we have many superstitions around money. And when those triggers come up, that's a beautiful thing, because we can catch them in a butterfly net and transform them into a positive, powerful energy that creates success or that creates the results. But if we don't look at our triggers and we just simply push them away, or we just always avoid thinking about it, that doesn't mean that they've gone away. That literally means that there is a kink in the cable. And you know, when you have a kink in your garden hose, you know it's going to happen. The water is, and you turn the tap on, the water is going to bank up on one side, and you know it's going to build a pressure till suddenly it will either just burst off the tap, or your hose will flip out of your hands. You've all seen that happen. So this actually happens. This can happen to us too, right? Because money is simply, the money that you have in your bank account is actually simply a clear photocopy of how much you're able to receive in your nervous system. And that's been programmed into you by your DNA, your childhood experiences, and probably many generations before you. And now is a really good time to deal with it, because the universe is kind of putting all of us into a constriction, right? So constriction is the opposite to freedom and expansion. So it's like everyone is fearful, there are no guarantees about tomorrow, so many securities are being taken away. It's like we're being stripped back and we're getting our noses wrapped into some ugly scenes and so on, and it's bringing up stuff for all of us. And then the money issues on top of that really intensify all this for us. And this is just the most wonderful way for us to change all that, to change something on the inside, so that the outside world changes as well. Because if you want results, normally even in a normal, safe, predictable world, if you want different results, we all know you have to change something on the outside, right? Maybe look for a new job or put in extra hours or whatever. But what people don't remember is that you actually need to do just as much work on the inside. In fact, the inner work, introspection and inner healing, is way, way more important than all the rest. So last week I talked about the base chakra a little bit. So I do like sometimes to connect these learnings with your chakra system, because the chakra system organizes our energy. We live in an energetic world. We actually have to learn to live by the energetic laws of the universe. That's much easier for us if we understand the language of the universe, right? And last week we talked about the base chakra and how you're born into your family, your tribe, you could say. And from the moment of conception, your soul or your beingness already starts to grow little roots to prepare you for your landing on planet Earth, right? And as those roots, they go out into your family, into your tribe, and you already start to absorb all their kind of habits. It does, whether they're dysfunctional or not, There is no filter, so that goes into our being for the first 7 years of our life. And then what happens next? Your sacral chakra kicks in. So this is the chakra that contains our reproductive system. It's a yin chakra, so that means it's a receiving center. It's the watery element. Anyway, all that stuff doesn't happen, but doesn't matter, I mean. But the sacral chakra has its own peculiarities around money, like its own little glitches, right? So the base chakra is to do with your tribe, and your sacral chakra kind of moves up a little notch from that. So it's still to do with your tribe. So I'm talking about tribe because there's so much peer pressure at the moment around, you know, what I'm talking about, whether you should have the jab or not. People have strong opinions about it, and people don't like to go against the popular opinion, right? Because our tribal energies are pulling us, we're feeling the pull, the gravitational pull of that, and we then don't feel safe or free to make our own decisions. So this all happens in your chakra system. And if you strengthen your chakras, you start to experience a lot of liberation and security and confidence that is regardless of where you find yourself in life, because you just carry that inside your body. And that's a beautiful gift. That's a beautiful way to live your life. So I just want to focus on the sacral chakra. So the sacrum is that big bone in your back that protects your reproductive system. It's called sacrum because it's a sacred bone. It's very, very strong because our reproductive system is considered sacred by the universe or by the creator. And but most of us have been violated at different times of our lives, including spiritually as well as mentally, and sometimes physically even, when our boundaries are crossed. And this all has an effect on our money. So how do you know if you have a blockage in your sacral chakra around money? Well, I want to just mention three things, only three things tonight, but I can think of a lot more, right? But one big thing in the sacral chakra that will block your money is if you have this superstition that you can't trust people with money, or people who have a lot of money can't be trusted. And so this is like, I call it a superstition, because it's not a truth, right? It's not true, because many people with money, or many rich people, can be trusted. There are many very rich people in the world who are donating from lots of money to different causes, and nobody will ever know about it. And this all happens privately. I'm not per se talking about Bill Gates or anything like that. I'm not talking about those kind of people. I'm talking about normal average people who have a lot of money, who are doing a lot of good in the world today. So there are lots of very rich people who can be trusted. And so when you come up against a belief like that, you need to turn it on its head. So then you could think, well, perhaps the opposite. What if the opposite is true, right? People with no money, poor people, can they be trusted, right? So you just play around in your mind and you stretch your mind a little bit, and that creates a new space in your thinking habits, like a neutral space for new ideas to come through. And those new ideas will be more in alignment with the abundance of the universe, because we're living in a very abundant universe. Like, money is literally coming at you through big pipes. You know, it's singing at you in the lounge room, you could say, just in the next room. And it's just a matter of how can you get yourself into alignment with that frequency, like mentally, physically, emotionally, and spiritually on all levels. And so in a minute I'll take you through a practice. But just to get back to that, what they'll call it, money superstition that often sits in the sacral chakra, that people with money cannot be trusted. If you have that in your body and you're not aware of it, you're going to attract people all the time into your life who will prove to you that rich people cannot be trusted, or people with money cannot be trusted. So you're going to come to grief there, because this is what happens. Because the universe will always give you what you believe, right? Even if it's a hidden belief, and the hidden beliefs are the most trickiest ones. Because our dominant beliefs are the most deeply buried, and so we don't even know half the time what we believe. That's why it's so important to catch yourself, think thoughts, and to be really, really honest with yourself. We think our noisiest thoughts are the most dominant ones, right? But it's actually not the case. They're just noisy. So if you have that kind of belief about money and trustworthiness, and you've kind of put them in the same bag, that's a little bit of homework for you. Just that you change that, and that you can say to yourself, I am trustworthy. You just say that out loud several times a day. I am trustworthy, and rich people are trustworthy. Rich people are doing a lot of good in the world. money in the hands of good people is exactly what the world needs right now, and so on. And then you neutralize that glitch in your body, like the kink in the cable, and money will start to flow your life. You'll feel supported. Nobody is going to take your money from you, right? Your money gets a chance to multiply. And so then point number two that sits in the sacral chakra is that people put their trust in the government or in an antiquated system. So like they'll say, I've worked for this company for so long, but you know, like maybe you're 50, you're sick of working for the company, but you keep investing your energy into it because you think the company is going to take care of you and give you pension when you retire. Well, in today's world, all that stuff is kind of dissolving now. And again, there are no guarantees. And so I believe this is one of the reasons why we are seeing a lot of issues in men with prostate cancer, because if they have put a lot of belief and trust into a career path like that, and then suddenly they get fired, lots of people are losing their job around the world. They feel violated like that. They feel like they've been betrayed. Their trust has been destroyed. And that again affects their prostate. We all know that prostate cancer is epidemic proportion at the moment. So a really, really good thing to overcome that is to actually to do the exercise that I'll show you later when I take you through meditation. So the trust and the guarantee needs to come from the inside, from your inner being, rather than from the outside, right? And so then a third one, this is also one that blocks people up, is that it's going to take forever for my money to build up, or it's going to take forever for all my plans to work out, or it's going to take a long, long time to get out of debt. It's going to take a long time, 25 years, to save up money for this or that. And so that comes from the same belief system that says when you're sick, this disease is going to take a long time for you to recover, and you have to have a million doctor's visits, and you need to stay on medical drugs for the rest of your life. It all comes from that same belief system where scarcity rules. And I want you to know that success and results come from a different place. They don't come from that place. You have to unplug yourself out of all those kind of old belief systems. You literally have to unplug yourself from your former tribe, from your peer group, if you want different results, and if you want to have great health, and if you want to do well, no matter what the economy is doing, or if you want to have more love, you have to do something different to how, where you grew up. Because, or to your peer group, right? This is really, really important. if you look at your peer group, the people that you hang out with the most, right, the five people in your life that you hang out with the most, there is literally a universal law that says that you are never going to earn more money than the average of those five, right? This is just something that happens to all of us because we all become, we harmonize ourselves to each other. So it affects your money, also your health. So the five people that you hang around with the most, and if you're plugged into them, that means you share the same beliefs, or maybe not all of them, but maybe you're not sticking up for your belief. The cells in your body are going to take on the energy frequency of the cells in their body. So if some of your friends are really sick and they have bought into that, that they're always going to be sick and they're always going to need drugs, it's going to affect the cells in your body as well. And the same goes for love as well. So like true love, if your peer group, the people that you hang out with, are not good with giving or receiving love, they don't know how to do that, that also affects your ability for the love to flow, right? So love is another currency that needs to flow and that needs the pipes to be open, right? And so many people don't know how to receive love or how to enjoy it or how to, they don't have the capacity for that. So this is just an aside. I didn't mean to talk about it, but it's still really important that you just, after the video tonight, just stop and think about who are the five people that I have most to do with and how are they affecting my life, right? And if it's positive, that's really, really good. And if it's not, like, if they're not supporting you, I'm not saying cut yourself off from those people. I'm just saying unplug yourself from what they believe and you start to foster different beliefs, right? So you can watch YouTubes, like there are many motivational or inspirational YouTubes that can change your thinking. You can watch, start to follow some very rich people and see how they're thinking, for instance, or you can, there's all sorts of opportunities open for us now that we don't need to fully rely on the physical people that we surround ourselves by, okay? So you can seek support in different areas of your life around on YouTube, like I said, podcasts. In the past, it was reading books. Now there are so many more opportunities for us that can offer us a contrast and that inspire us to change something about ourselves. So lots of people get triggered about money, right? And so like they get frustrated if I would say to them, just imagine you have $100,000 in the bank and you can touch it today and it's always there and it automatically fills up. Lots of people feel triggered by that. They literally can't do that. So tonight I want to give you a little bit of a sense of freedom. So freedom comes when we have no pain and when we have abundance and when we have space and when we have money, right? And when our relationships are safe. And so we're just going to go in through the back door. So let's just forget about money right now and just talk about or imagine the energy of freedom, right? So I want you to think of the fact that you can walk out your back door or your front door right now and you can look at the stars outside, right? Nobody's going to stop you, and that's all available to you for you to receive. So you can look at the stars and you can inhale the beautiful fresh air outside. you can turn on some music that you enjoy, or you can go to the kitchen and turn on the tap and drink a glass of water. This is all free and it's part of your freedom that's given to you. And just feel the sense of gratitude and appreciation also for yourself. Think of the cells of your body. Just think of one cell, just even just one cell in your body that's working away behind the scenes right now to keep you alive, to keep everything ticking over. Just close your eyes and feel into your body. Behind your eyes, right behind your eyes, there's a real, real quiet space. And that's where the divine energy, the energy of the universe, of pure consciousness, meets with you. It's like a meeting spot behind your eyes. And just enjoy the feeling of sitting there. You can even go further back, a little bit further back. And then after a while, you start to get this incredible sense of freedom and quietness. And that's the space where the universe meets you, and that is where all possibilities arise from. So just think of all possibilities, infinite potential. And just be plugged into the universe where changes can happen in the blink of an eye. Miracles unfold every day. You're part of that miracle. And just feel a sense of appreciation in your body that you're connected. You are important. Your life matters. Your life is important as Mount Everest. And the universe is taking care of you and is guiding you. And it's all for free. And just drop into your own heart now, in the back of your heart. And just notice how soft it feels, and warm, and welcoming, and connected. And again, your ability to feel so much love. And just think of like your favorite pet, like your cat or your dog or bird or spouse or child. Just feel how much love you feel for that being, and it's all being generated in your own beautiful heart. And then you can drop down into the sacral area, which is the area we're talking about today. And if you like, you can visualize a beautiful, like, soft orange glow. The orange is the color that keeps your sacrum healthy. It's a color for blessings, for bliss, finding your own bliss, and just in stepping out into the unknown where there are no guarantees. And that's fine, because the universe is supporting you. The universe has created you, and the universe is keeping everything in order. Nothing needs to change. And the universe is interested that you thrive, that you enjoy abundance, that you can shine, that you tune into your gifts. And just feel the freedom of all of that. And then just drop through your legs, through your bottom, your knees and your feet, and anchor all those feelings deeply into the earth. And just feel that calm, solid presence of Mother Earth, which is also always tuning into you. And just feel your whole beingness being supported, feeling freed. You are a timeless, immortal being. And nobody can put constraints on you. And just feel your breath flowing through your body. You're free to breathe. And there's so many things to enjoy. And just feel that sense of liberation and expansion. Everything is in perfect order, and right now nothing needs to change. And you just feel that your body, which is the container or the receptacle, is like a little bit bigger now than when we started 20 minutes ago. You just feel calmer, more peaceful, and your capacity to receive good things is bigger. It's like more flexible, you're more open. Just think of beautiful rose petals. And spring is just around the corner, being out in nature. And just absorb all that in your body. You feel that positive transformation in your body. And you can trust nature. You are trustworthy. And the universe trusts you with your journey. So just sit with all that and feel the change in your body and just feel how solid that is. And that's the real guarantee, right? The universe shows up for you every day. You show up for you every day. And your body shows up for you every day. And that's the real, real only guarantee that matters. So just breathe into your body and then you can open your eyes from behind your eyes and you feel that your internal state has changed now, right? So that this is how you bring yourself into alignment with what's already playing out for you in the next room, right? So like your wishes, your desires, the things that inspire you, the things that you want for yourself are never very far away. Like they're not 100 miles away. They're already just in your next room. And it's just bringing yourself into alignment, feeling calm, allowing your body to open up, become restful, and then freedom, that sense of freedom comes in, that has its own wave of energy that allows better and bigger things to flow into your life. So I hope that you really enjoyed this little chat, listening to me chatting away. And just unpacking little bits and pieces about money and abundance and health and relationships. It's all the same thing. You are the central core where it's all happening. And so I work with people to get them out of a state of a holding pattern of pain and stuckness so they can enjoy greater results and have more happiness and more flow. And you shine your light so everyone around you benefits as well. Because the universe actually is not interested in keeping you small. The universe wants you to be rich and healthy and prosperous. Hi Cinnamon, hi Karina. Good to see you here. And I'm just finishing, so maybe you get a chance to watch the replay. That would be good. I nearly put myself to sleep when I was tuning into my inner core. And hope to see you all next week. Have a really, really great week, everyone. Stay safe and stay warm. Bye. Bye-bye.